At the outset, I'd like to thank the government of Andhra Pradesh for giving me an opportunity to be here. To support the visionary and dynamic leadership of the Chief Minister, Sri Chandrababu Naidu, on the development of sports here in Andhra Pradesh. It's such a happy coincidence that on Swami Vivekananda's Jayanti, we are gathered here to celebrate the commencement of the Andhra Pradesh's strategic sports initiative. Tenwick, the company that I established, with the specific intention of providing a best-in-class platform to sports development in our country. So it's indeed a great privilege for us to be a part of this program in supporting their initiative. Thank you, Mr. Subramaniam, Dr. Bangaraju. I think with the kind of leadership that is there here in Andhra Pradesh, and the leadership that has been shown for the development of sports, I think you are in safe hands. I am really glad that Andhra Pradesh is the first state who has partnered their sports authority with a private partner. I think that shows the vision and the leadership that is existing in this state. Swami Vivekananda famously said, "Take risks in your life. If you win, you can lead. If you lose, you can guide." And I think sport teaches us every day. Every day, you can't win. There will be days when you have to lose. That's when I believe that you need to start guiding. What were the reasons for you to lose? And when you win, it's good to lead. Take leadership. And that is the message that was given by our great leader, Swami Vivekananda. I think India as a country is blessed to have such iconic leaders. And Dr. Subbarao and Dr. Prabhakar mentioned in their speeches about so many leaders who have inspired all of us. So we don't need to look anywhere else. We have enough icons who we can look up to for guidance, for help, to look at their values and tread their path. Cricket teaches us everything that life teaches us on the field of sport. I was really happy and pleased with the way the students from HEAL organization were performing before the start of this program. Sport teaches you that. Sport teaches you discipline and never really worried about the distractions around you. I could see the performers. There were media, there were people crisscrossing, but nothing deterred them. They were performing and focused entirely on what they have to present. And that is the value of sport, and that is something that I inculcated from the discipline that I chose, which was cricket. I was fortunate enough to represent the country at the highest level, and like Dr. Subbarao mentioned in his speech about how Vivekananda in Chicago said how we can unite irrespective of our caste or other opinions that we may have. But one thing is for sure, sport brings in patriotism, brings in togetherness, and all of us, whether we come from the lowest strata of the society or from the highest strata of the society, whether we are educated, whether we are not, whatever it may be, whatever problems that we may have, when someone is representing the country, the whole of India comes together. That's the value of sport, and that is the message that I'd like to give all of you. Please take up any sport. It doesn't really matter which one you want to take up. But that will bring you a lot of discipline, and that is something that I certainly value in my life. What is required for the development of sport? Infrastructure. You need trainers, coaches who have played and who have competed, who have been able to achieve in their respective fields. Then you need talent. I believe that talent is immense in India. We have talent in nook and corner of this country. All we need is opportunity. And I'm really privileged and pleased that the government of Andhra Pradesh, through their sports initiative, have taken that step towards providing infrastructure. I was just talking to Dr. Bangara Raju this morning, and he was mentioning that there are 1,200 athletic tracks across Andhra Pradesh. I think this is unheard of. So there is infrastructure available. Coaches will then put the trainees in their respective disciplines, and with quantity will come quality. And once you get quality, once you start putting them through competition, then you will understand the value of the talent that is coming out. Once that is addressed, then it's very easy for us to give them the support, give them the regular training, give them scientific methods of training and a center of excellence. And I'm also pleased to know that the government here is putting together a center of excellence to make sure that the talent that has been identified will get the world-class facility and world-class support. And that's something that, sir, through this medium, I'd like to assure you of our support in that regard. If you have the passion and desire, you can certainly achieve any goal. Before I end my speech, I'd like to again quote Swami Vivekananda. Take up one idea. Make that one idea your life. Think of it, dream of it, live on that idea. Let the brain, muscles, nerves, every part of your body be full of that idea. And just leave every other idea alone. This is the way to success. And this is from Swami Vivekananda. With that, thank you very much and wishing you all very happy Sankranti. Thank you.